Hello everyone. In this video, Flicker and I are testing an Ursa rover with two size 1 distortion repeaters against different targets. Error, Craycat Buggy, Cyclone, Ursa rover and Nova tank, and we want to find out if we can shut down those two. About the head bobbing, this is not caused by me. I have everything I can shut down or put to zero. But it's caused by distortion guns moving ships and vehicles around like crazy, especially smaller ships and vehicles. This is not intended and CIG will address this. Yeah, none of my game settings have any influence on this head bobbing. Thank you very, very much again to Flicker for all the help, all the suggestions, and let's get started. We have now an error. I have landing gear down because I might just fall down. Flicker is in the Ursa rover and Flicker has two size 1 distortion guns on the turret. Okay, I'm looking at my MFD. Fire when ready. Again, head bobbing. I'm getting moved around. Yeah, those guns are moving my head and the ship around. Now I see distortion bars, I think. Hard to tell. And I'm shut down. Ship is shut down. But I can still move, okay? Yeah, shot placement is very important, I guess. Engines are not shut down, so I can still move. And I'm back up. This was interesting because he was shutting down my ship, but not my engines. And again, shut down, but not my engines. I'm trying to restart and let's try again, but this time aim at the engines. Trying to restart. And I will turn around. So yeah, like I mentioned in previous videos and in this video, shot placement can be very important. Flicker was shutting my error down, but not the engines. And this time Flicker will hit at the rear when my shields are full again. They are not recharging yet. Okay, shields are full. This time Flicker will aim at my engines. Okay, fire when ready, Flicker. Shields are going down. My arrow get a bit moved around. Shields are down. I see long distortion bars over both coolers. And distortion bar over power plant is around 40%. Okay, still no shutting down. But both coolers are at zero usage. And now we are offline. Okay, I survived. Yeah, both coolers had a max distortion bar. And power plant was at around 40-ish. Then I guess after power plant took more distortion damage, power plant was shutting down. Let's see if I can restart. Yes, I can restart. Now we have a Craycat Buggy, the golf cart. And Flicker will try to shut me down. Okay, fire when ready. I see coolers, I see drivetrain. Again, head bobbing. Head bobbing is back. Yeah, okay, I'm shut down. I see no more power usage of Froststar and drivetrain, and I'm shut down. I cannot move. Try to restart. Okay, I can restart. So you can even shut down a golf cart. That's very interesting. Okay, again, shut me down. I can still drive. I see no more power usage of coolers. Please continue shooting. And I cannot drive anymore. No more power usage of coolers. And look how much you are getting thrown around. That's exactly why you have those head bobbing, this head bobbing. Okay, I cannot drive. I am trying to restart. This is really silly, how much you are getting moved around. I want to watch this in third person view. By the way, this is exactly why my head is bobbing. Those are little explosions and you are getting moved around. Okay, I am now watching this third person view. Okay, continue firing, please. Move my buggy around. This is kind of silly. Maybe CRG wants to look into this. Those are tiny size 1 distortion guns. It's not me moving my buggy. Shouldn't do this, so I guess CRG has to fix this. Now we have Encyclone RC. I'm looking again at my components. And locked on to MFD. Okay, fire when ready, shields are full. Again, head bobbing, head bobbing, head bobbing. I can't see anything. Okay, pin shield is down. We have a very long distortion bar. Cooler has a long distortion bar. And now we are off. I cannot move anymore. We are offline. There's a really, really long distortion bar over pin shield. Coolers are coming back. I'm trying to restart. And I'm restarted. Shields are still down. There's still a distortion bar around 60% over pin shield, which is still down, which still doesn't need any power, and shields are still not back up. Yeah, shields take a lot longer to come out of distortion damage than coolers. Now it's around 30% over shields still. Now they are coming back up. And now we have an Ursa rover. I'm looking again at my components and I will again have a lot of head bobbing, I guess. Okay, Flecker, fire when ready. Yeah, head bobbing, okay, this. I just try to look like this. I don't lock onto my MFD anymore. This only makes it worse. Now shields are down. Okay, engines down, powertrain is down. Okay, I cannot move. Guns have a very long distortion bar too, and cooler. Yeah, I stop locking onto my MFD with middle mouse button because it only makes it worse with this head bobbing. But I can restart right away. Now we have a Nova tank. I will again look at my MFDs and I won't lock onto them. This only makes it worse with the head bobbing. Okay, Flecker, fire when ready. Okay, shields are going down. Shields are now at 60. Shields at 40. Shields at 10. Shields are down. No distortion bars yet over anything. Okay, that's interesting. No distortion bars. Yeah, maybe you really have to hit those components. I don't see any distortion bars over anything. You're hitting one pin shield. You're hitting the Slayer cannon with distortion bars. And I see distortion bars on the guns on the mini turret. But in a Nova tank, shield generators are in three different spots and you're only hitting one spot. Which is quite interesting. So looks like you cannot shut down a Nova tank. Let me show this to the audience. So in Nova tank, your components are distributed. You have your power plant shield generator here. You have another power plant shield generator here. And another power plant shield generator here. And Flicker is only hitting this one. But those two are not hit when Flicker is aiming at the front of the Nova tank. This means It might not even be possible to shut down a Nova tank with those size 1 distortion guns, which I find really interesting. Because two of the shield generators and power plant are in the rear. Okay, let's try this. And I'm looking at my components. Fire when ready. Shields take damage. I guess those guns are just deactivated. It wasn't you. They are just down. Now I see bars over two pin shields. Those are the pin shields in the rear, I guess. Okay, and now we are shut down. I have two pin shields with max distortion bar, one pin shield without distortion bar, but we are still shut down. I guess you are hitting other items. It's really hard to tell. Slayer can have a very long distortion bar. Nothing over coolers, nothing over drivetrain. I think vehicles have a power plant that doesn't appear anywhere. Let me check quickly. Yeah, all vehicles have a Radix power plant, but it doesn't show up on any component screen. So I guess Flicker was hitting the Radix power plant. Actually, Nova Tank has three Radix power plants. So I guess this is why Flicker was able to shut me down. I'm trying to restart, and I can restart. Okay, and now Flicker tries to disable my Slayer cannon, which of course works. Fire when ready, Flicker. Shields at 80, shields at 60, 40, 20, shields down, and now I see a distortion bar building up over cannon. Still works, around 60%, and I cannot shoot anymore. Okay, cannon is deactivated. When the bar was around 70%, I couldn't shoot anymore. I'm trying to fire, nothing. Bar is now at around 70%, trying to fire. Okay, at around 60%, I could fire again. Let's talk about what we just saw. Distortion guns work in 3.15, they do shield damage and are shutting down components when shields are at zero. Distortion guns have a small area of effect damage radius. We were able to shut down every ship and vehicle we tested, but we couldn't completely shut down a Nova tank. Nova tank couldn't move, Nova tank couldn't fire the guns, but MFDs still were on. My guess is in Nova tank, shield generators, power plant and coolers are distributed in three different spots. You have three of each, so you cannot shut down everything with the area of effect damage radius of a size 1 distortion repeater. Shot placement is important, especially against bigger ships and vehicles. You need to know where those components are located and you have to target them. Thank you very much again to Flicker for all the help. I hope you found this interesting and informative, and see you next time. Bye! Auf Wiedersehen! How about our little rocket launcher? Goodbye! Okay. This was a kill. How about our little rocket launcher? Goodbye. Okay. Goodbye. Okay.
this was a kill.
Hey, you are still here. You might want to join me on Twitter. My Twitter account is Kameral_FFM, and this is the city I live in, Frankfurt am Main. On Twitter, I post about my videos and sometimes just some funny little videos.
Action!
Would be nice if you would join me on Twitter.